Our guest today is Dr. Shen Ming-shih, Acting Deputy CEO of Research at INDSR. Dr. Shen, what is your response to reports that China was sending civilian ferries across from Taiwan to conduct amphibious landings last week?
Yes, we can see recently, these 2 weeks, PLA organized an exercise, a big exercise in opposite of the Taiwan Strait. And then you also can see some private or civilian ferry join that exercise. This ferry is belong to the Bohai group, Bohai Jitan. Why PLA use this civilian ferry to join that exercise? Because you can see that right now, PLA, their navy, they don't have enough amphibious ship. For example, 071, 073, and 075. Because they don't have enough amphibious landing ship, so they need to use and organize or mobilize this civilian ferry to join the exercise. But the trouble is we can see that our civilian ferry, it don't have enough weapon system. And then it's big ship. Although they can bring around one battalion, maybe army, maybe Marine Corps, and join the landing action, but it's very weak during this ship on the sea because our anti-ship missile from F-16, from naval ship, from even from submarine, can easily destroy this civilian ferry. So if one civilian ferry destroyed, it means that more than 700 personnel also be killed in that destroy action. So you can see because they don't have enough amphibious landing ship, so they organize and mobilize that civilian ferry. Of course, every country will do that. Because in Taiwan Strait, if want to across Taiwan Strait and Taiwan some the so-called Red Beach, China PLA need more soldier landing because in Taiwan we have more than 200,000 men, and then so it need to organize more than maybe 70,000 personnel, Marine Corps and Army, and then amphibious landing. And then we'll be have a possibility of success.
Now, why did China send 103 aircraft during talks between Wang Yi and Jake Sullivan in Malta?
Yes, you can see, I think that Wang Yi and Sullivan talking about that how to increase the interaction between China and United States. I don't think they were talking about or maybe China very angry about the result of talking about the Taiwan Strait issue. I don't think they have a direct relation between the Wang Yi and Sullivan conversation and the Taiwan situation. I think Taiwan situation is because I just mentioned before that recently PLA had big exercise. And of course, PLA Air Force need to organize big exercise to echo Navy exercise. So you can see that they organized more than 100 airplane, including drone, including reconnaissance airplane, fighter, bomber, air tanker, etc. And we can find that one PLA officer mentioned in the newspaper say, that is a typical operational level campaign, air campaign. So you can see it just simulated that if one day PLA want to invade Taiwan, what kind or what type of PLA Air Force will attack the action to the Taiwan Strait.
Hmm. Yeah. And so these exercises were something that were planned in advance and probably was not related to those talks then.
I think it's just an air campaign plan exercise. They try to use, because you know, when military take a reaction, first one is that you need to have a plan and how to handle and how to make this plan reality is very important. So you need to have an exercise to try to practice, to try to make plan to be a real action and win the campaign. So not only this year, we can see that before this year, maybe several years ago, China already sent their fighter, their airplane, cross the middle line, and increase Southwest ADIZ. It's all two meaning. The first one is normal training. And then I practice, and if Sunday, I will invite Taiwan, how PLA Air Force to take action. The second one is I use this normal training. I exaggerate the fighting action or fighting result or fighting effect and make some recognition operation or implication operation. Or China will make it from its propaganda system to exaggerate its effect, try to scare Taiwan people.
Mm-hmm. Interesting. Switching gears, how do you see military ties between Taiwan and India increasing in the future?
Yes, this is a very interesting question. Yeah, because rarely people will ask, Taiwan relation and India in security. Most of the people ask economic, culture, trade relation between Taiwan and India. Because I've been to India more than 10 times. And then I'm a visiting professor of the India RRU University in Gujarat State. So I really understand that Taiwan-India relation in, especially in the security area. I think three reasons that Taiwan and India security relation development. First one is both Taiwan and India have common enemy, China. And then Taiwan in the east and India in the west. So if Taiwan and India take strong action against China, will force Taiwan to face two fronts. Then, and then if United States and Japan support Taiwan, I think east side pressure will be stronger and bigger than Western. Then you can see that American general once say that if China invade Taiwan, maybe India can react some or organize some action on the West. So this is the thinking. Enemy is enemy, it's friend. Because India and Taiwan had common enemy, and then security cooperation is better to India and Taiwan to against China. The second point is right now we can see under the leading of the United States, democratic world try to organize the alliance, democratic alliance. You can see also the, India joined the Quad, and then United States, Australia, and United Kingdom also had AUKUS. And then right now, United States, Japan, and Korea also organizing alliance in Northeast Asia. So right now, India don't want to be the alliance of the Quad because India have a tradition non-alignment. But it's good it have a big interest for India that if democratic alliance stronger can make some deterrent effect to China, not to invade Taiwan or not to make trouble in the East China Sea and South China Sea and even China-India border. So it's good for India to join the democratic alliance because Taiwan's because China factor, so Taiwan cannot join this collective security regime. But if Taiwan and India, because of likely mind or likely value, and then can stand together to against China, I think it's beneficial to the both country. The third one is Taiwan can provide some good or interest to India that another country can provide. For example, if India try to understand PLA, maybe India will through that English literature to know or to understand PLA or China. But I don't know you know this, because Taiwan, we learn and study China and PLA for a long time. So we have some achievement that about the PLA study. So right now we have some think tank exchange is talking about the PLA research. So if Taiwan can share some PLA research to India, will make India to know more about PLA and know how to prevent and how to defend. And the last point is, you know that the Confucius Institute is withdrawn from many countries. If Indian government or military try to learn or study Mandarin, right now they cannot send their official to the mainland China to learn. But if stay in India, only India teach Indian Mandarin. So if Taiwan and India increase the cooperation of Mandarin teaching, already start, because Tsinghua University right now send more than 20 teachers to India to teach them Mandarin. But if Taiwan can send more teacher, Mandarin teacher, can teach them Mandarin or military Mandarin or some PLA course, I think it's good and helpful to India. Yeah.
That's very interesting. Yeah. Military Mandarin, it makes total sense.
Yeah, military Mandarin yeah. is, for example, if India troop along the border, and then from radio they learn and hear some voice, but that's a military term. Mm-hmm. If they not learn about military term or military Mandarin, they don't know what it's speaking about, even you have learned Mandarin.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'm not even sure if I would understand, even though I've studied Mandarin for so many years.
Yeah.
It's very interesting. Yeah. Does the launch of Taiwan's new indigenous submarine change the China's calculations for a possible invasion?
Yes, I think it's very difficult for Taiwan to develop our own IDS, our own submarine. So it's a big achievement for us to underwater capability. I don't think only one submarine can deter China to invade Taiwan, but I think it's a symbolic achievement to Taiwan. It means that we already can do our own submarine, and during the wartime, we can make more submarine to defend China invasion. But the second is, because you know, we already have four submarines, two only for training, and two can join the operation. Right now we have three. China's strategy, military strategy to Taiwan is divided two parts. One is A2AD. A2AD is anti-access and area denial, and try to not let the United States and Japan military intervene the Taiwan Strait, the A2AD. The second is amphibious landing, or occupy the official island and then amphibious landing Taiwan home island. The submarine can put, they have some function to do that. The first one is to help United States and Japan submarine and Navy to attack aircraft carrier of PLA, east side of Taiwan. And the second is that this submarine can also put some sea mine along the port, of China, and then let their ship cannot go out to invade Taiwan. The third one is along the slack. Along the slack, our submarine can stay the seabed and ambush. If China Navy ship cross that area, and our submarine can ambush that ship. So submarine is very important. It can take some offense action. It also can do some asymmetric operation for us. So it's very important to us. But only one is not enough. And then I hope that if United States or United Kingdom can help us, made up another 7 submarine can complete quickly, I think it's better for us.
Now, there's been a lot of talk about China invading in 2027. Do you think that's a realistic timeline for the PLA?
Okay. You know that timeline is from Admiral Davidson. Admiral Davidson, in hearing in Congress, he said in 2021, he said after 6 years, PLA will have capability to invade Taiwan. So that timeline was 2027. But you need to aware is after 2021, because the United States sanctioned technology sanction to China. And then because of COVID-19 and made China economic decline. So I think that 2027 will more delay than the military capability will more delay than Admiral Davidson say. And also because this timing is very important for Xi Jinping and PLA. You know that 2027 is the PLA established for 100 years. So it's symbolic meaning for PLA. If PLA can invade and occupy Taiwan before 2027, because all PLA 100 years have very big achievement in 100 years. The second point is you can see that in the 20-party Congress, Xi Jinping not nominate his successor. It means that Xi Jinping will try to move to fourth term, his power fourth term. And then that the party Congress will organize in 2027. So if Xi Jinping try to continue his power before 2027, he need a big achievement to persuade his partner, his party, to let him fourth term power. So he will try to unify Taiwan before 2027, or even a big achievement. Maybe one country, two systems already succeed in Taiwan. Or maybe if Taiwan not obey, not accept his political precondition, maybe Xi Jinping will use force to force, will use military to force Taiwan to accept that condition. But if Taiwan not consent, maybe they were rising or organized a military action to force Taiwan to accept. So they did timing. But for me, I don't think that the timing 2026, 2027 is not important. That the condition is more important than timing. Three conditions will invite China to invade Taiwan. The first one is if United States abandon to intervene, to protect, to defend Taiwan, maybe China will invade Taiwan. The second is PLA full of confidence, saying, okay, if PLA invade Taiwan, will defeat United States, or make United States afraid of PLA and not intervene Taiwan Strait. And then maybe PLA will invade Taiwan. The last one is if PLA or China think Taiwan defense capability is very weak, and even people's way of fighting is very weak, and then maybe we'll invite China or PLA to invade Taiwan, because they think they can close this war or this conflict in a short time, and then let the war or let the United States cannot in time to intervene this conflict.
Interesting. Do you see any other possible scenarios, such as a blockade or an invasion of a smaller island, something like that?
Yeah, any action have is a political aim, a political object. Why you choose blockade to Taiwan? What is your object? If China object is try to blockade Taiwan in order to make Taiwan accept a political precondition or make Taiwan, force Taiwan to talk with China about unification, I don't think Taiwan will accept. So Taiwan will take some military action to counter, to against the blockade. Of course, Taiwan right now in liquid gas, natural gas, because all liquid gas is import from outside. Right now we have the so-called security storage, maybe 10 days or 14 days. If China blockade Taiwan, our liquid gas maybe have some problem. But we need to increase some different source, maybe from Australia, from another country, and then we can ask United States, Australia to make a safe channel to import that we could get. Of course, you can see right now, we have different power source. We have fire power, hydro power, and even. And then if our nuclear power already can start, it can use, maybe can even no liquid gas, and then we'll maintain our power to continue to operate. Yeah, and then of course we also can use our submarine, our aircraft, our navy ship to against the blockade. And then, but it's very difficult for PRA to blockade or surround or quarantine Taiwan because it need to send many ships, many airplanes to surround Taiwan. And then how to continue his power to blockade is the first question. The second question, if you blockade Taiwan, it means then also blockade the channel, the so-called lifeline of Japan and Korea. If you blockade Taiwan for 1 month, and it means that Japan and Korea also cannot import many things from overseas. And then as the regional country will protest or help Taiwan. Yeah. But if you take quarantine, before the war, you quarantine the Taiwan, of course, Taiwan can use our military system to destroy, to attack you. That's another scenario. Yeah.
Very interesting. Thank you, Dr. Shen, for joining us today at Taiwan News.
Okay. Thank you very much, everything. Yeah.